There's an ancient parable about six blind men and an elephant. The six blind men heard that an unusual animal had come into their village, so they said, let's go find out what this animal is. So they went to the elephant, and the first one reached up and grabbed its trunk and said, well, an elephant is like a large snake. The second one reached up and felt the ear and said, oh, an elephant is like a fan. The third one reached down and found the elephant's leg and grabbed that and said, no, you're both wrong. An elephant is like a tree trunk. The fourth felt to the side and said, no, an elephant is like a wall. The fifth grasped the tail and said, an elephant is like a rope. And finally, the sixth blind man felt the tusk and said, you're all wrong. An elephant is like a saber. All of them had some idea of what an elephant was, but no one comprehended the entirety. They had partial understanding, partial truth, but it was a question of perspective from where they were standing, what they grasped. No one has complete comprehension of anything, probably. In today's gospel, the second Sunday of Lent, we always hear the same gospel story, the story of the transfiguration, the story of the vision of Jesus in glory. Why is this? Why is it that the other gospels of Lent on the other Sundays all change, but on this Sunday, in all the A, B, and C cycles, it's always the transfiguration? Perhaps to help us focus on our Lenten journey. Our Lenten journey is not just a pilgrimage to a place, but even more so, our Lenten journey is an interior journey, a journey into our hearts and a journey into the heart of Jesus Christ. Every year at Pasor, which is coming up, faithful Jews try to make a pilgrimage to Jerusalem, but many of them can't. And so they pray the words of Psalm 84, verse 5, which says, how blessed is the one whose strength is in thee, in whose heart are the roads to Jerusalem. It's an interior journey for Pasor. If you can't get to Jerusalem, you journey to Jerusalem in your heart. That's where the roads are. And that's where the roads are for our Lenten journey. Yes, we may go out. We may come to church perhaps to pray a little more. We may go out to do acts of charity. We may make those journeys. But our Lenten journey also has to be an interior journey. And so in this interior journey today, we find ourselves with James and John and Peter on the top of Mount Tabor, the site of the transfiguration of Jesus. And we know that mountaintops are always significant in the scriptures. They're places where most of the most important things happen. Sinai, Horeb, Tabor, and of course, Calvary. Now in today's journey, in today's version rather, of the transfiguration story, which Deacon Justin just proclaimed from Luke, we hear that Jesus is in discussion with Moses and Elijah. But Luke tells us what they're talking about. He says they're discussing with Jesus his exodus from Jerusalem, his own Passover. And like the Passover led centuries before by Moses of the Israelites out of their slavery in Egypt to freedom in the Holy Land, Jesus' Passover will be a passage from darkness to light, from death to resurrection. And it will be a passage not just for Jesus, but for all those like the faithful Jews that followed Moses, for all of those like us who journey with Jesus, it will be our Passover too, our Passover to true and eternal life. Now commentators have suggested that on this mountaintop, it was not Jesus who was changed, but it was his disciples. Jesus is always the fullness of the glory of the Father. But his disciples finally realize this. They comprehend who Jesus is. The transformation is not in Jesus, but in them. It's not a case of sight, but a case of insight. They have a truer vision of who Jesus really is for the first time. The great Canadian Jesuit philosopher Bernard Lonergan wrote his massive work, his classic work, Insight, a Study of Human Understanding, and contained this concept that he said that every human person has within us, each one of us, an unrestricted desire to know. Each one of us wants to find the truth. Each one of us asks questions. But so often, our search for the truth, our search for understanding, our search for insight is compromised because we have our blind spots. He calls them scotoma, We have our blind spots caused by our bias, our prejudice, our arrogance, our pride, which sometimes keeps us from asking the further questions. It keeps us from going beyond the surface. Like the blind men in that parable of the elephant, we think we have the answer already, and so we stop asking questions. Insight, you see, is not just a question of more data or information or facts. Insight is comprehension. Comprehension not just with our minds, but with our hearts. Like those wonderful words in The Little Prince, when the fox tells the little prince, it is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. This second Sunday of Lent, we are called to focus our Lenten pilgrimage on the heart of Jesus Christ and to see Jesus more clearly, to love him more dearly, to follow him more nearly. In his confession, St. Patrick, whose feast day we celebrate today, set before the eyes of the Irish people and before all of our eyes, in the midst of our difficulties and darkness of our life and our world, the image of the dazzling radiance of our goal, our life in Jesus Christ. He said this, "The sun, which we see rising for us each day at God's command, that sun in the heavens will never wane, nor will its splendor continue forever. But we believe and adore the true sun, that is Christ, who will never perish. Nor will they perish who do his will, but they will abide forever, Jesus, just as Christ will abide forever." As we heard in our second reading, our mortal bodies will be changed to be a body like his in glory. May our Lenten journey bring us deeper into the heart of Christ as we see the true radiance of his love. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Christ is